Welcome to our mutual fund update videos. This video series started as a pharma fund recommendation video. We have come about seven videos now. As pharma funds have started showing weakness, probably it will get out soon. To continue this journey, we have moved this into a mutual fund video series where we will talk more about all the funds, all the sectors in the economy. So to begin with, let's see where the pharma recommendations have been today, and further we'll go to next other opportunity that is there. As vaccine is getting discovered, there are about 2 to 3 companies which have gone to third phase of human trials now. More drugs have come into the market. Governments have started putting penalties and controlling the prices of the drugs. So again, about 10 companies have got licenses to manufacture the drug. These all will bring in competition and reduce the prices so that companies will lose their edge in the market. So as the market started seeing this, probably that is the reason why stocks have started showing signs and they have become fatigued from their journey. Because we had a very good rally in the last 3-4 months. Now it's showing signs of weakness. Of course, it is not got out still. It can have still more rally happening. So as the stocks are doing this journey, what is the condition of the funds that we recommended? These are the 3 funds which we recommended. Again, the reason we chose was market has started coming from the bottom. In that, pharma space showed signs of strength. Among them, we wanted funds which had a long track record. So these were the 3 funds which had long track records. At the time when we recommended on 1st of June 2020, these were the NAVs of the funds. And at the time, what was the risk that each of the funds carried? So like SBI was recommended at 141.8 rupees NAV and stop loss was at 134.95. This means if the investment has to go against us, where we will have a protection. So if buying at 141.80, if it goes against us, we will get out at 134.95. So after we bought, the fund started moving up. Today it is at 151.92, made about 10 rupees gains from the place where we purchased and about 7.14% gain on the investment. Today the stop loss has moved to 146.55 from 134.95. So it has gone above the price we have bought. Same it has happened with UTI and Nippon also. All the stop losses have gone above the prices where we have bought. Among the performances, SBI have been the top performer, Nippon is the underperformer. Reasons for that, Nippon had some stocks which were not doing well and they did a churn. At the time of the churn, they lost some money. So those were the reasons. While of course, it is not the end now. Chances are whatever stocks they are having now can have a rally and changes, things can change also. As of now, SBI is leading. So if we had invested 10,000 rupees in each of the funds, what would be the returns? Number of units we would have got from SBI was 70, Nippon 53 and UTI 97. Risk per unit at the time when we bought was 6.85 in SBI, 9.11 in Nippon and 5.11 in UTI. It doesn't mean UTI is the low risk investment. If we see that is a unit risk. If you see the percent risk, it is all equal. For a 10,000 rupees investment, SBI carried 483 rupees risk, Nippon was having 489 and UTI was having 495. So we can see here UTI is the highest risk among all the 3. As we have passed 8 weeks since we gave this recommendation, where is the investment now? Investment value as of 24 July is 10,713 for SBI, 10,640 for Nippon and 10,700 for UTI. Capital risk, the 10,000 what we invested, if we have to get out now, what we will lose? We are not going to lose anything, we are going to gain about 335 rupees. The present stop loss for SBI is 146.55, currently trading at 151.92. If suppose it has to go down and hit 146.55, we will get out with a profit of 335 rupees in SBI. While Nippon and UTI, we will have a profit of 225 and 275. Profit risk, from where we are, this from 10,713, if it has to hit this top, how much we will lose? 378 rupees in SBI, that is the least we are having to lose to stay in the market, while in Nippon it is 415 and UTI is the highest at 425. What this means is, from this investment can continue to go further up. In between it can have a volatility, it can go down also. So suppose we want to participate in the upside journey, how much is the risk we will be carrying? This much, 378 in SBI, 415 in Nippon and 425 in UTI is what the risk we are going to carry. In between this, it can play and go around, turn up. If suppose it is not going up, it goes down, we are getting out, giving away this much of the profit. So this is the profit risk that the positions are carrying. So where is the money invested? Here, these are the top 10 stocks of all the funds, all the three funds. These green bars here indicate the large cap stocks in the pharma space where all the three funds have invested. You can see here most of the green bars have started going down in the table. This is because all of them are in the negative territory. Last 1 week they have lost money. Very few stocks, which again not all the funds are having, one or two are having those stocks that is going well. Here we can see some unique change that has happened. Nippon sold off Biocon 2 weeks back and brought Fortis inside. At that time Biocon was doing extremely well and it seemed like Nippon is doing a wrong decision, while that was probably a right one. Their Fortis has given nearly 7% return this week. In last week also it was given around 8%. Syngene also is being profitable for Nippon. So 2/3 of the total stocks in the top 10 universe has started going down. Lupin leads their rally downwards. Lupin has lost around 5%, and this stock is there at higher percentage in all the funds. So obviously all funds would have taken a big hit, and again Nippon is not finished its journey. It is having a potential to go up. As of now, it is weak. Syngene and Fortis made a change of destiny for Nippon. Sometimes this is what happens in the market. We cannot predict or give a guarantee about what will happen. While have a system and play with the system, do what it is to be done as per the system, you will make money. That's what we are doing here. We didn't do any magic in identifying a fund or a stock or anything. We just took the strengths and played on it. Now, the journey of 10,000 rupees in SBI, how it has been. 10,000 rupees when we invested, if it has to hit a stop loss, we will get back only 9,517. 483 rupees was the risk we were carrying on the investment, 4.83%. On first week, it went to 10,264, giving 2.64% gain. As the price went up, stop loss also started climbing up. Then from there, on fifth week, it went to 10,363, making around 3.6% gain. Stop loss came up to 9,922. In case something had gone wrong and we had exited here, we would have lost only 78 rupees of our investment. While in the 5 weeks, we made around 3.63% profits. It's open profit. After that, it had a small dip and started going up again. In 7 weeks, investment goes to 10,766, making 7.66% gains in 7 weeks. And stop loss also moves up along with the price movement to 10,335. Here, profit is locked at 3.35%. Now further 1 week from there, prices slightly dropped, stop loss is remaining the same. As of this place, as the funds as well as the stocks are showing weakness, it is good time to take some exit on pharma funds. Like say 50% of your investment you can move away, looking around 7.1% profit. Balance you can leave it there, as it is locked with 3.35% profit, you can make more returns also. So for conservative or even general investors, we would suggest take a 50% exit, book 7.1% profit, balance you run it, if there is a gain, add to that. So as pharma is coming to an end of its journey, what next? In the markets, there is always opportunities available. If one stock goes down, there will be another stock blooming up. Like that, in the country today, technology segment has become a bright shine. It is shining bright. Reason all of us know, due to the pandemic and disturbances that was created across the globe, world is going to digital. All the banks and most of the companies are looking at digital platforms, enhancing their spend on the technologies requirement. This has brought huge opportunity for technology companies in the world, and since in technology we lead the world, at least in the servicing side, we have Infosys already booked about $1.5 billion worth of contract in the financial space in the last 10 days. All the other companies also gung-ho about their projects in the coming year. So that is why this sector has started showing signs. How we found out? IT sector index, NSE IT index, has had 30,000 crores of purchase in the last 20 days and 10,000 crores of sales. Net-net, 20,000 crores of positive money. That is, buying has been positive 20,000 crores in the index stocks alone, IT index stocks. This has propelled the gains and brought in a huge strength. And while this price is going up, all these stocks have also rallied heavily. What are the stocks to look at? HCL, Infosys, Wipro, Tech Mahindra, all big names. TCS is not participating in this. I don't know, because TCS has shown some kind of weakness in their results. While investing in stocks will be highly taxing because you have to do a lot of analysis and work on that. Most of them, I would not recommend to go into direct stocks because it requires effort. While this series also talks about mutual funds, we will look at what are the funds to look at now. Go take some focused funds, because focused funds invest only in 35 stocks. Out of them, if suppose they are having 5 IT stocks and having exposure of 20-30%, chances are they can have. That will give huge returns potential. While we have to identify funds which has that kind of exposure. Similarly, large cap funds which has IT exposure, look at exposure somewhere around 18-20% in IT space alone. Multi cap funds, here advantages, mid and small cap stocks also in the IT space have started moving up. It is a broad based rally that is there in the market now. Mindtree, Emphasis kind of stocks have also started going up now. So having a multi cap fund will give a larger space, and mid and small cap stocks give bigger returns than large caps. So somebody can look at also multi caps, which will have a subtle rally. Those who are aggressive can look at tech funds, predominant investments in only tech stocks, like what we are doing in pharma funds. There is a tech funds also available. About 3-4 funds are there in our market which you can look at. Already they have run up heavily, while patterns show that there is a lot of strength left to be, a lot of space left to be covered. And there is one new breed of animal that is there in the IT space, US tech funds. One mutual fund house is having a fund in the name of Edelweiss IT US Technology Fund. This fund is, in the last 6 months, have given around 30% returns. Very good fund. I would recommend about 10% exposure for all of your portfolios. In your portfolio, have 10% of US tech fund, which will give a different kind of dimension on the returns. So as of now, pharma is going weak. Tech has started taking that place. So in this video series on mutual funds, going forward, we will talk about other opportunities that is there in the market in different sectors, different stocks, different funds. Even we will talk about specific funds in some weeks, so that it helps viewers to take advantage of the knowledge that is shared, do your investments and grow your savings. Thank you.